you got your funky bus fare. There's a double dutch bus coming down the street, moving dirty fast, so kinda shuffle your feet. Get on the bus, pay your fare, then tell the driver that you're going to a double dutch affair. The double dutch bus is on the street. You better get off the curb, move your feet. Bus fare, transpass, that's the way my money lasts. Ain't got no car to get around. When I go to work, I gotta go downtown. Now I miss my train, that's a common shame. When I'm running late, no streets to blame. If you got a wife, you know I'm right. You got a special man, well I can understand.
I was always masculine. There wasn't really a big difference between back then and now. I mean, even since I was 2 years old, I would only wear boys' clothes. I actually cut my hair off all on my own, and I wore boys' clothes. That may sound strange, but it's true. If you see pictures of me when I was 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you'll see I have short hair. I wore a lot of blue. I wore clothes from the boys section. Unless my parents told you I was a girl, you wouldn't know it. I was really aggressive, and I guess that's got a lot to do with, I guess, the testosterone. You know, boys are more aggressive at that age. I don't know, that's what I heard anyway. Also, I was really into, like, my Ninja Turtles. I mean, I had Barbie dolls too, but I would just use them to fight, you know, like play a game of combat between the Ninja Turtles and the Barbies. So it wasn't like I was trying to dress them up and comb their hair and whatever girls do with them. It wasn't like that. I didn't think anything of it at the time, but now looking back at it, I can see how that would be considered abnormal. I did wear dresses, like, when I was around 8 to, like, 9 and a half. But that's because I had to. I was into modeling, and that's something my mom was really, you know, like, she was really set on, is making me a model. Because that's what she did, that's what my grandmother did. So, you know, it's just kind of like a family tradition. And for that, I had to wear girly clothes. I had to have my hair kind of long. It wasn't like really, really long, but just long enough, you know, that you know that you're a girl, basically. And it was okay. I mean, I was able to do it for a while. It, you know, I wasn't comfortable, but I did it because I kind of knew that that's what you had to do in that business. And the only thing that was really, really a struggle was the makeup. I couldn't wear makeup no matter what. I couldn't do it to save my life. And it didn't matter what kind of makeup. It's just, I hated it. So my dad, he was kind of against makeup too, because he's kind of like a health nut. So I kind of used that as leverage. You know, my mom would try to put makeup on me. I'd be like, "Dad, she's trying to put makeup on me." And he'd come to the rescue. They'd be in a big fight. It's not that I want to see my parents fight. It's just that's the only way I knew how to defend myself. And, you know, that's basically how it worked in my house. So anything I did when I was about 10 years old, that's when I couldn't really handle it anymore. Because I was modeling for about 2 years, I'd say since I was 8, or like 7, I don't remember, but I know it was about 10 years old when I stopped. I just couldn't do it anymore. I couldn't even handle the dresses, I couldn't handle my hair being that long, looking so girly. I couldn't deal with it, so I cut my hair short like I did when I was little, and I looked like a full-blown boy. And I think that's why at the age of 10 is when I was first asked if I was gay. I was asked that by a girl, and of course, I wasn't exposed to that stuff. I didn't know what it meant. But looking back on it, I can see why she would ask me that. Because, you know, I didn't look like the other girls. And though I did like girls, I liked them because they were the opposite of me. I saw that as normal, you know. I was attracted to the opposite. Girls were basically the opposite. So I didn't think anything of it. I didn't know what gay was. I just said no, I wasn't. Because, you know, if I don't know what something means, I'm not just going to be like, yeah, that's what I am. I'm sorry for this video coming out so terrible. I mean, I couldn't get any privacy again. It's really difficult around here, and the traffic was insane. But thank you for listening.